Hello everyone, this is Danial. I'm the TPS Solutions Architect at A10, and in this session, we're gonna talk about remote triggered black hole routing, or also known as RTBH. RTBH is a very common technique used by many service providers and large enterprises to protect against the DDoS attacks. The idea is to block the traffic at the edge before it actually enters the protected networks. Well, in today's world, the DDoS attacks itself comes in many different shapes and forms. It could be an application level attack, it could be a protocol level attack, or it could be volumetric in nature itself. The whole intent of the attacker is to make the service unavailable by consuming all the network and application level resources. So when it comes to network layer protection, this is where RTBH plays its role. And if I go by the definition, right, RTBH means that all traffic to a certain destination is routed to a black hole, which is equivalent to dropping the traffic. Now, with that being said, let's take a look into it. I will start off by drawing an ISP core. And let's say I have a few edge devices providing internet connectivity. And then I have a provider edge device providing service to one of my customer. Let me just write it down. And let's say this customer is hosting a web server, and let's give it an IP address, right? For the sake of simplicity, we'll just say it's using an IP address of X. Now, when the attack happens, let's say the attack starts and, you know, the attack is coming from random spoof sources, then it's going to try to take down this web server. Well, another side effect of that is that it's not just an attempt to take down the server, but it's also going to impact the ISP core network, and perhaps it could cause degradation for other customer service as well. Now, so we need to block the traffic at the edge of the network. So how RTBH works is there are three important things. First thing first, we need to have a discard route. Let's say AVIA now zero, a discard route pre-configured on all of these edge devices. The second thing we need to have is a BGP policy, and that's where it gets interesting. So we need to have a BGP policy that's going to say that if I receive a route update with a certain community, and if it's a match, I'm simply going to go ahead, and for the given specific prefix, I'm going to change the next hop IP address to the IP address that we have actually configured in the discard route. So this is how it's going to look like. We're going to match on a community. For example, let's say this community being Y, and we are just asking it to change your next hop to the IP address that we have used in the discard route. Now, we have this thing pre-configured. What's going to happen now is whenever an update is received with a community of Y, the match is going to happen, and we're going to change the next hop pointing towards the null route. Now, the question here is, who's going to trigger that update? Well, for that, we need another device in the network, and we're going to call this device a triggered device or a router. So this triggered device needs to have IBGP pairings with all your edge devices, right? And this triggered device, let me write down device. This trigger device needs to be configured with another BGP policy, right? And this policy is going to actually redistribute static route with community that this guy is actually looking for, which is going to be Y. So now, when the attack happens and you need to block the traffic at the edge, that somebody, being a network admin or a system operator, needs to log in to the triggered device and simply add a static route with a certain tag in it. And this static route will be redistributed using this BGP policy and will be advertised toward the edge devices. The match is going to happen, and eventually the traffic will get blocked on your edge devices, right? One thing I would like to highlight is that in A10's DDoS protection solution, this whole process is actually completely automated. I mean, if somebody is using, you actually don't need a trigger device, that's what I'm trying to mean. If someone is using A10's TPS device for providing DDoS mitigation service or maybe infrastructure protection, all they need to have is IBGP pairings with the edge devices, and whenever a certain entity is under attack, and if the action is to blackhole the traffic, we can simply, in an autonomous fashion, advertise a BGP update with a certain community that edge device is actually looking for. And that's how the traffic will get blocked. Thank you for watching this video, and hopefully we'll see you in the next session.